You have asked for this, and now it is finally time to talk about the fortress. Yes, this is the ultimate fortress guide for beginners and more experienced players, as it features every bit of information I can think about. So everything will be mentioned from the building's basic description to the best ways of getting lots of resources. As always, timestamps are in the description. The fortress is unlocked at level 25. For the beginning, it really is crucial to save up some gold because upgrading buildings is incredibly expensive at this point. The main building increases the level cap of all buildings, and upgrading it also unlocks new buildings. Here you can see a list of that. The laborer's quarters reduce build time, and they really are crucial for progressing fast in your fortress. The easiest way to gather a large quantity of resources is by attacking enemy fortresses. There are just two buildings that are important for that matter. The barracks, which increase the maximum amount of soldiers by 3 per level, and the smithy, with which you can increase the soldiers level, but more about that building later on. The fact that raiding other fortresses, especially at the beginning, is very rewarding, makes those two buildings essential for fast progress. Now let's get into some tips when attacking. In general, if there are large rewards, you should always go for the attack. But in case the target is too strong and you have to skip it, there are 4 different options to do so, which are ranked from good to bad. Going to your battle history and counter-attack players that tried to rob you is one of the most viable options, because this can get you a lot of resources and sweet, sweet revenge. Wait for a free reroll, which is available every 5 minutes. Just raid the target with a single soldier and lose this fight, through which you can access a new target, but this option costs time and resources. And at last, you could skip the target with gold, but it is not recommended to do so. Another important aspect that you have to regard, especially at higher levels, is that not every fortress is worth to attack. But honestly, this is not a problem at all at the beginning, but has to be put in consideration in late game. There are 2 buildings that produce resources, but overall that way of gathering resources is not even close to being as rewarding as attacking enemy fortresses. You need to build the wall, the mage's tower and archery guild to be able to build the smithy. With this building you can upgrade the 3 different type of units, but for the beginning only the warriors are important, as those aid you in raiding enemy fortresses. It is recommended to improve the level of your attack units only when you see that you cannot raid any fortresses with a single unit anymore. It is important to keep the gem mine on the lowest level as long as possible, as gems are much cheaper that way in every sense. The mining costs way less gold and resources, and the time it takes to acquire gems is significantly lower. For that matter, it is recommended to keep the gem mine on level 1 until you are close to unlocking the tower. Then you need to upgrade it to at least level 10 to be able to collect the Heart of Darkness, which unlocks the underworld. Here is the gem formula for people that are interested. The treasury increases your backpack space, really useful to start a coin collection. The academy is another source for XP, which I forgot in the other video. And well, thinking about it makes me sad. This is not really a building. It can be accessed by opening the fortress and clicking the according button. Through upgrading it, you and your guildmates can get better gems. Every 3 levels of the Hall of Knights adds an additional point to the stats of a gem. As soon as someone reaches level 15 on the Hall of Knights, everyone in the guild can get black gems. The chances increase when more members reach that level. For your information, black gems provide you with every attribute instead of just one. So especially in early game, those are extremely advantageous. At the beginning, it is not worth to put any attention into defense. In that category are following buildings: the wall, the archery guild and the mage's tower. The only reason you should upgrade all of them to level 1 is to unlock the smithy. For the late game, it of course becomes useful to also get those to a higher level. And you might ask why upgrading the defense is so useless. The reasoning behind it is that in comparison to how much resources and building time it costs to upgrade those buildings, it is clearly worth to completely ignore them, as every lost battle activates the partial protection anyway. Partial protection is an effect that stays activated for 24 hours and reactivates if robbed again. Through this protection, enemy players can steal way less resources from you. Normally, you can lose following resources: 50% of the resources that are still in the production buildings, plus 10% of the stone and wood that is stored in the fortress. The partial protection completely removes the second parameter, making you lose just a small amount of resources if defeated. First, the fortress of course, as this increases the level cap of all buildings, but it also is important to keep the laborer's quarters on the same level, as this saves you a large amount of time. So next are the buildings that you need to gain resources, but it is pretty much common sense that those are worth a lot, hence why they also have a high priority. On the number 5, there are buildings which mostly depend on your situation and personal preference. All of those buildings have some advantages, but in general are not useful at all to progress as fast as possible. And of course, in the last place, there are the buildings that are necessary to defend your fortress. I hope I mentioned everything. In last minute I thought about something, but then I forgot. I hope this was not a deal breaker for you. And I hope I can see you. I hope a lot. I hope I can see you next time. Goodbye.